Hey guys, it's Victoria Gallagher from hiptalk.com. I just want to say thank you to all the wonderful people out there who have been sending me wonderful comments and enjoying my videos. It really means a lot to me. So thank you and keep watching. Today we want to talk about communication. What happens when we talk to each other? The first thing you want to understand is that we all have our own map of reality. Something happens in the world, an event happens, or somebody even just says something to you, and it gets interpreted by another person in a whole different way through their map of the world. And so I want to kind of go over a little bit about what goes into making that map, because we all have one. We all have our own basic perception of how we see things and how we interpret things. And understanding this information kind of helps you to get inside the mind of others and understand that, people's communication and what you're hearing and what they're seeing is not always the same thing. It's not reality. It's your reality and their reality. We take in information about things through our five senses. That's the first level. And because our subconscious minds are so sophisticated, if we were to be exposed and be aware of and be totally conscious of all the data that's happening all around us all the time, the clock ticking, you can hear that, but you're filtering it out. You can see things going on around you, but you're filtering that out. You're not paying attention to every piece of data that's happening. So you have all this data, and you take in that data only through your five senses. You take in data through what you see, hear, feel, taste, and smell. All right, we all know what our five senses are, but those are the only ways that we get data. So it first comes into us through our five senses. Now, when I say data, I'm just talking about every single thing that is happening all around you, the something like 60,000 bits of information that are coming to you. I mean, when you're driving down the street, okay, you have so many things happening all around you. You see ads and you see it all and experience it all with your subconscious mind. But in order to make sense out of these things, the subconscious mind has designed a filtration system that helps you to only have to deal with a little bit of data at a time so that you can make sense of it and so you can experience it and so you can respond to it. Otherwise, you're responding to all this data. All right, so the first level of this is called your filter system. All right, and your filter system has five different processes. Imagine it kind of like a funnel, all right? And the very first level of that funnel are your values. Your values for how you feel about money, how you feel about health, how you feel about security, how you feel about your finances, how you feel about love, and all of those things. So, when you, it's kind of like your spam filter in your email in a way. So you already know that when you see an email and you're not a smoker and you see an email about smoking, you're going to delete that. So automatically, this basically says yes or no. Right or wrong, bad or good. Okay, it kind of just puts it into a system so you don't even have to think about that one. That's your values. Then you basically have your beliefs. Okay, these are the things that you have a strong belief about way deep down inside. Now, where did your beliefs come from? Your beliefs came from your, they could have come from your parents. They could have come from your friends. They could have come, they could be something that you have a lot of experience with, and it could be something you have very little experience. We have beliefs about things that sometimes, we just only hear a message once. And because we have very little information about that, we've just decided that that's true. Your memories make up a large part of your filter system. You have memories about all kinds of things. So when some piece of information is coming to you, your subconscious mind is going, oh yeah, I remember that situation. That was great. That was not so great, whatever it is. So you have your own set of memories about something and it goes through that filter. Two more to go. You've got your decisions that you've made about something. So your decisions can be something you've just decided whether you have experience with that thing or you don't have experience with that thing. You have made a decision. Maybe you got into a bad relationship and whenever somebody does this to you again, you're never going to you're going to break up with them or you're going to, you know, decide that, you know, it's over. And then finally you have your meta programs. Now you have a lot of different meta programs, but I'm speaking specifically about your perception, how you see things. Are you looking at this from your own point of view or, you know, how would somebody else see this situation looking at you from another perspective, from their eyes? So you have your perception. So you've taken in the information through your five senses. You've gone through the first level of filtering, which is your values, your beliefs, your memories, your decisions, and your perception. All right, that's just the first level of processing. Then we go through a second level of processing, and that's a three-step process. The first level is your generalizations that you make about things, all right? So those sound like this always happens, every time, always. Never. Okay, it's anytime you're saying things like that or thinking things like that, she's always late, all right? So you're going to expect that. The sun always rises, all right? You kind of expect that. So these are your generalizations that you've made about pretty much everything that you have ever experienced or come into contact with. Then you have your deletions. Now, I'm sure that you've heard of people talk about selective listening. So you delete out things that you really don't need to hear in order to make sense of what's being said to you or make sense of what's happening to you. So you just kind of delete that out because it's just not necessary information. You only are looking for the information that kind of validates your understanding and your interpretation of the world. And you also distort things. Again, based on your map of the world, you have a tendency to hear something and it kind of gets distorted so that it matches our reality. Okay, so that's what's happening when we communicate. We have all formed this kind of map of reality, this map of the world. And so it's a wonder that anybody can ever really talk to each other or get any kind of understanding going on with each other, because while you have gone your whole life creating this map of your reality, this map of the world, when you're hearing something that somebody else is saying to you, you're not hearing what exactly from their experience and their map of the world what it is that they necessarily intend to get across. So there tends to be sometimes this miscommunication that happens between people, and now you can understand why. And now you can understand that in order for you to be a much more effective communicator, it's important that you recognize that we all have this map. We all have kind of the way that we see things. So in order to communicate better, it's important to just acknowledge how another person interprets and sees the world and to be able to get inside their head and get inside their shoes. And then the real communication starts happening. Not the you're right, you're wrong kind of conversation, but the real validation and the empathy and the communication and the understanding that people are looking for. And when people feel that you truly understand them, that's when you can really begin to impact them with what you want to communicate to them. There's so many other things I want to talk to you about when it comes to NLP and improving your communication through NLP. This is probably the most boring part of it, but it's important to understand this foundation. And so continue watching the videos as they come. I'm Victoria Gallagher from HipTalk.com, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Thanks for watching. Hey guys, it's Victoria Gallagher from HipTalk.com. I just want to say thank you to all